Start the recording from your end. Okay, start. Welcome everyone in the hands-on session. So in this session, we'll yesterday's session, we have seen that how many tools are there and what is the use of these tools, how can you use that tool for what purpose. We have discussed that, and there we have found out that we have a one central structure editor, one is central's process, central's visual, and inspect will use, and as device for the simulation purpose. So today we'll see the main, one of the main component tool, that is the central structure editor, how to create a semiconductor device structure in any semiconductor, in this Synopsys TCAD tool using the central structure editor. And later part we'll also see that how this edited option or edited structure can be used to generate a as devices file. Okay, so let's start with the central structure editor. So I have already opened it. So this is the central structure editor, and as you can see that in the command line, that this is totally blank. If you see that, so we'll start from the scratch. So simple, let's have a drawing first of how we want to make our device. So like the previous one, we'll have a silicon body. Today we'll create a device which have a silicon body, and in that silicon body we can part it in a three part. One is source, another one will be the drain. Okay, and above that so there is a suppose this is a oxide layer. This is the oxide layer, and above that we'll have a metal contact that will be maybe polysilicon, tungsten, gold, anything can it be. So so if we write in this way, this is will be the source, this is will be the channel CH, and this is will be the is this drawing is visible, or I need to zoom in? Participants, is it visible or I need to zoom it?
Expand it.
Okay, if in any point of view you are facing any difficulty, just interrupt me.
Now it's okay. Now it's okay.
So we have first a blue line is the silicon body. Then we have formulated a source channel, and then we will formulate drain source channel drain region. This is will be the red color will be the oxide region, and the top blue green one will be the your metal part. Okay, so totally it is a metal oxide semiconductor, and we'll place also contact over here. Okay, contact over here. There's a source contact over here. Drain contact over here. Or drain contact you can place in the right side also. Okay. I mean, suppose I'll show you in both the directions. Suppose if you are placing this. Suppose drain contact here and gate contact. This is like gate one. Okay, so this all black colors are mentioning the mainly your contact lines. We can make it different color to make it more understandable. So the three different color for the three different contacts. Okay, or you can have the body also. It is depends on you. Or we are mainly formatting three terminal, or let make it four terminal. So if it is a four terminal, we need to short it here little by little bit, as we should not connect the drain terminal, or we can place it over the top of the drain region also. Okay. So let's make it this type of kind of figure. Or we can move it to the here. They are this side also to make it more suitable for the application purpose. Okay, so let and now fix the dimensions. Suppose total side length is 100 nanometer, or it will be 0.1. micrometer. Okay, the total body length will be this one. If total body length is that much, then now if we see the all the coordinates what we are using in our devices, so it will be initially this coordinate will be 0 0, so this coordinate is 0 0 this corner, this corner is 0 0, and if we see, so we make this corner as the length is 100 nanometer, and we are thinking about its thickness. So thickness will be near about, you say, 30 nanometer, or else you can say that it is 0.03 micrometer. Okay. Yeah, 0.03 micrometer. Okay. Now, if we see that our first, if it is 0.03, 0.00, then this corner will be its, and I am placing the that one also, x direction and y direction. Suppose this direction is X, this direction is X, and this direction is Y. Okay, so if it is a width is a 30 nanometer, then this corner should be, if we write in the coordinates according to the coordinate system, so this corner should be how much? It will be x-axis, it will be 0.1, and y-axis will be 0.03, because y direction is 0.0. So let me. So we'll definitely say that this is the coordinates. So when we figure out the coordinates, it will be better for us, because in future when we are actually fabricating, we need not to think about that one. So if it is, I will always recommend everyone should, when you start your first time you are creating your device, you should ready with your coordinate, your topping position, and all other parameters. When you have started with that one, vision of your device, that time nothing should hamper your work continuity. Now, actually, we are, as per the yesterday's discussion, we only need two vertex, only diagonal or diagonal and two vertex. So, if I am taking this one, means we are taking this as a diagonal, and for each and every region, while we'll define the square region, then we'll take this diagonals, means leftmost right corner to rightmost lowest corner. Okay, so this diagonals, I need all the corners. Okay, so all the necessary corners can be figured out. So how many corners? One. This corner I need to find out, this corner, this value I need to find out. Again, if you want to go from this direction or this direction, this depends on you. So I probably go from this direction to this direction. So I will need to find out all these extra corners. Okay. So I will have the vertex of this diagonals only, and I will be ready to go for the creation of the device. Okay. So these black lines are mainly the diagnosis which will be need to be used in the future, future when we are creating the device. So how much it will be? This one will be I think x-axis will be 0. Oh, okay. So for before that we need to find out the how much length of the source. So length of the source length of the source we can say that this is also a 30 nanometer 30 nanometer source 30 nanometer nanometer source and drain also we can say that it is will be also near 30 nanometer. This small space is there, so we'll go for this direction. Okay. Is also 30 nanometer. So if it is a 30 nanometer, so this what will be the force of this one? What will be the coordinate of this one? Let me make it in white color. It will be clearly visible then. I think now it's clearly visible. If it is a 0.0 is earlier, now it will be increased by 13 nanometer to 0.03 and y-axis is all obviously 0, it will be 0. And if we go to the next coordinate, next coordinate, what will be the coordinate of this one? This will be if it is a 100 nanometer, it is 30 nanometer, it is 30 nanometer, then obviously channel will be over 40 nanometer. So 30 plus 40, it will be total 70, so it will be 0.07 and the y axis will be 0. And finally, our last coordinate of the top vertex will be this one again need to be black. So now it will be 100 nanometer. So it will be 0.1 and 0. Obviously. So it will be 0.10 and below that one 0.1, 0.03 because 30 nanometer our width of the device. Now if we want to select we need to add this. So what will be the this value? This value will be 0.03 micrometer by 0.03 because its x-axis is 0.03, the 30 nanometer axis is 30 nanometer y-axis. Similarly, 0.07 70 nanometer of x-axis, 30 nanometer of y-axis. So we have figured out for this vertex both the coordinate. For this vertex we have this diagonal with both the vertex we have. For this diagonal also we have both the vertex, and for this diagonal also we have both the vertex. So we can create now all the sections. Now we have left with 1, 2, 3 points. Okay, now let's start with this. Smaller. As I can place more near to that. Okay. So how much it will be? The x-axis will be 0.07, obviously. And y-axis, if we are taking this line as a zero, then upper side will be what? Negative y-axis. So it will be minus. And if its thickness is, suppose we are taking about 2 nanometer thickness, so it will be 0.002. Because obviously 2 nanometer means 0.002 micrometer. And y minus? Minus because we are taking this reference line or this line as a reference. This line as a reference for the our x-axis is equal to x-axis, and below that axis it is positive y, above that axis it is negative y. So that's why its value is minus. Okay, so let me delete this. Okay, so now we have to find out. I have left with the two more vertex. So this is will be obviously 0.07 because same y x point. But y point will be different. Suppose we have more 2 nanometer of metal layers, so it will be overall 4 nanometers. And now we have left with only one position, that is this one. So this point is 0.03, means 30 nanometer of x radiation, so 30 nanometer. And this will be same as the like the this one, so it will be only 2 nanometer of y, so it will be 2. So now we have all the coordinates for creating or for generating a device in our sophisticated tool. So sorry, am I audible? Do you have any doubt in this section? If you have any doubt, you can ask me right now, or else we can proceed to the software extension to fabricate this device. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir. Very clear. Yes, sir, very, very clear. Okay. Very clear.
Okay. Okay, thank you. So now we have to think about the doping concentration also. Just creating a NPN channel MOSFET, then it will be suppose n-type doping concentration 1 18. Okay, this 1E18 means it will actually mean 10 to the power 18. Okay, 10 to the power 18. Okay, so if you want to write, suppose 5 into 10 to the power 18, what you will write? You will write 5E18. So that is the means representation in the scientific EA. So let's say we have started the N type. First is, let me write, it is a N type and it is a n-type and it is a 10 to the power 18 concentration will be there in this region. Suppose we have thing. Now for channel, it will be obviously p-type, and concentration maybe let's think about something 5 into 10 to the power 16. So we will write into 5e16. Okay, now again, if you want to do in the deep brain side, suppose we have the similar concentration like our source site. So it is also suppose n type 10 to the power 18 or 5 into 10 to the power 18. You can do anything. So let me now we have the doping concept, we have the dimensions, we have the material properties. Now we can forward for the processing of the device. Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, is there any rule regarding the selection of the doping concentration, or we should consider the moderate doping or the high doping or the low doping? And the second thing, so the substrate that is there, it is just common. It is common. Do we need some separate kind of substrate material, or do we need some separate section for the source and drain region?
No, it's depending upon you how you want to create your device. Okay, in that as I will show you, you will find out that you will have the different region. You can define the region wise silicon. This region is silicon. Different one silicon region can be defined as a different silicon region also, or you can define as a whole, and you can part it for the source, channel, drain, everything. So now you will see that one. Okay. And regarding the concentration part, it depends on the which device you are working, what type of output you are trying to achieve. It depends on the theoretical analysis part. Okay. It's nothing to do with the software part, because that all the physical parameters you need to be predefined by yourself before starting of the fabrication or preparing the device in the software. Because whatever it is your application, whether it is your device will be you preparing for the device for the RF application, high power application, low power digital application, or you are preparing for the only analog application like amplifiers kind of thing. What type of device you are making, that actually decides the how much concentration is there, what will be the device thickness, what will be the device length, and all the other physical parameters. I hope I can clear your doubt.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's start with this. So we'll start with this. Let me a little bit zoom out this. Okay. So we know how much thickness it is. So now I am just only concentrating over the coordinates. So. The structure is visible, I think. So we'll just see in the left side the structure, and we'll try to draw the same structure in this central structure editor. Now we'll click on the how we got this big window. We have in this central workbench, that is SWB, which is the main our control panel. That from we go to the extension. If anyone to write, or anyone first time you are seeing this one, I will suggest to write the steps. It is if you are interested in futurely in future you will work in this software, it will help you definitely. So first you will go to the extension, then from extension you will go to the run central structure editor, and when you click the run central structure editor, you will find this window. Okay, you will this window will open, and after that we have already are there or we are already prepared our all the physical parameters which is need to in your hand before starting the creation of the device in the software. So when you have all the physical parameter and you have done with your physical work or physical calculations, so you will come here, you will click on the draw, you will select the exact coordinate. You are you able to see that one? This is a you can, if you are in mobile, you can touch the screen, or you can zoom that section. because in that in my case I can't use that zoom section. So it is exact coordinate. You will click that one, so it will activate your coordinate system for the creation of the device. Okay, after that you will click on the 2D create tool. Okay, in 2D create tool you will see that is it visible to everyone? So from 2D create tool we'll select the rectangular region, because all the our section is rectangular form. So we'll select a rectangular region and we'll start dragging. And before dragging we need to see the which material is there. Now it is silicone. So if we are if we are creating the silicone body, then it is good. But if you are creating oxide body or metal, then we need to select the particular material from above that list. Okay, so now first we are creating silicon and we have selected the exact coordinate on. You can see the coordinate is on or not here also. That test corner, rightmost corner, that is written is exact coordinate. The tap button will be pressed if it is already clicked. So then you will press the left cursor and then you will drag and this window will appear at exact coordinate. So exact coordinate that will be I am creating for this one and this one. Okay, so we are creating for this one and this one. Okay, so if we are taking these two, then we'll get this window. But if we take this and this and this, then we'll get this window. And if we get this and this, then we'll get the whole silicon body. So that's why we'll take first coordinate as a 0, 0 and last coordinate is a 0.1, 0.03. That will be, that means it will hold silicon body will be declared or fabricated, you can say that, or added in the simulation. So 0 and 0, and second vertices will be 0.1 and 0.03. So XY first vertex 0, 0, second vertex X is equal to 0.1, Y is equal to 0.03. If you click OK, so you see that this command section is blank. Currently it is blank. When we'll click on this one, the corresponding command required to generate the same kind of action directly. So that command also will be generated here. So if we press OK, see one command window is there. And if we click, this is the magnifier option, zoom to. Okay, so it will show this one. And our X direction is currently in the lower direction. So we need to fix that one direct coordinates. Now it's correct. See, now it's as per our drawing, that X is in this direction and Y is in this direction. Okay. So if X is in the right direction, lateral direction and particle direction Y, and it's a downward direction. Now we have the exact look like this one only, this particular diagram only. So after that, we'll again, we'll, now we are actually, as compared to the fabrication, we are mainly actually the depositing all our materials here. Okay, so now in the second part we'll do a rectangular. Yes, exit coordinate is click. So we'll select the oxide material. Which oxide material we want to select? Suppose we are want to choose HFO2. Yes, high K dielectric. So HFO2 CFC. It is HFO2 is already selected. Okay, color has been changed. HFO2 is already selected, and now we'll click and drag again. Exact coordinate is there. So now we'll keep this coordinate and this coordinate, these two coordinate. Then if we'll give this coordinate and this coordinate, then it will create this red color oxide region. So suppose your first coordinate is 0.03 and Y will be 0, And second partix means this one. This one will be 0.07 and minus 0.002. So 0 and minus 0.002. Okay. When you will press OK, it will create a section over here. Okay. Let press OK. Oh. What we have missed? We have done one mistake. As you can see that there niche, that our x was, and x was 0, that's why it's got 0.07 and minus 0.002. Okay, now we got our exact, you see, we got our oxide layer, 2 nanometer oxide layer of 30 to 70 nanometer of our device. Okay, so after that we will have to deposit one polysilicon or something like that. So we have we need to select, suppose it is gate polysilicon. Okay, suppose, so this is the gate polysilicon we have already selected. Now we'll again left click and drag, then we'll get the coordinate. So now we'll take this coordinate and this coordinate, means the green region, two vertex we'll have to consider, and first vertex is 0.03 and second y axis of this vertex is minus 0.002, and the second vertex of this section is 0.07 and y axis will be minus 0.004. So this is the two vertex. If we click OK, then what will happen? It will come above this one. Okay. So OK. So it will fabricate it, or we can deposit it our polysilicon, gate polysilicon layer above the our oxide. Okay. And the, you see, the, each region has a different color, and each material has a unique color. So this is the silicon, pink one. Then that is almost gray color one, that is our oxide layer HFO2, and the dark pink one is a gate polysilicon. Okay, so this is our device. All the materials already have been fabricated or already have been placed. Okay, now if we now with what we will do, will the next step, we'll add the contacts first. Let's make the contact. So go to the contact, and if you zoom in here, you can see that the contacts, there is a set contact is there. So we'll click on the set contact sets, and after that contact sets, you need to write the name of the contact. If you are using source, the source, and this is the color combination, means 8 different individual color you can create. Means 000 is a binomial combination, 2^3 is 8. So this 8 combination color can be possible. You can make face pattern, you can change thickness, you can leave it as a 4. So suppose we have started with 001 000 source. So we'll, when we click the set, means it will create the contact. Okay, now source contact has been created, or defined contact set, which is source is there. Now we'll click on the source and we'll activate this one for the use in this window. So we have click on the activate. Now it is activated. If you see in the line section, one first line here, it is source generated, and second line command for the activation of the our device. Now after source, it is, if it is suppose we need to convert a gate. So we now change the color combination, such as face pattern also, and then set, then gate activate, same process, then brain contact, suppose make it 1, face pattern different, set, brain formulated, it created, and we need to activate for placement. Now if you need a body, then body has been set, created, and it is activated. Now all the 4 contacts we have created, what we have, you need to use. Now we'll close this window, and we'll see that if we when we'll place want to place these contacts, we'll see that all the contacts will be available for the placement. So if you now select, we need for the selection of anything, now we have in the debt cursor where we are to draw something. Okay, now we need to get out from that, and we need to deselect that, and we need to select the selecting pointer. So selecting pointer is left side row uppermost corner. That's a selecting pointer. So we need to click on the selecting pointer. After that, we'll get this one. So previously, that was one circle was there above that one, this pointer. Okay, if we again change, see one circle is moving along with that. And if we click that, that circle will be removed. Okay. So when this circle is not there, that means you are on the selecting mode only. And now what you will select when you click, you will select the body. Means whole body will select. Okay, whole body will select. And which one you will select, it will become orange color. Okay. Now, in place of body, I want to select the edges only. Edges, why edges? It is a two-dimensional. When we are fabricated in a two-dimensional, mean that means if we rotate it, you will see that is a very thin kind of device. See, only very thin kind of device. But it is actually, it by default, it is taking one micrometer of your width of the device. Width of the device is 1 micrometer. So we can add space, and when we use the three-dimensional structure, then we can use we can use space. Now we'll use only edge. Edge means when we select this edge, that means along with that, whatever means one micrometer length is there below behind that one. So that 1 micrometer length will be selected by default. Okay. So if you want to place the contact, so we'll click on the edge, which edge we want to select. Suppose this is the edge. So this point to this point. So we'll click on the right click on this edge. After left click, then right click, left click means we'll select this edge, then we'll right click, then here we're going to place the contact. We'll see all the option. So go to the contacts and you see the source, drain, gate, and body, drain, body, all are there. So it is a source side. So we'll obviously add the source side contact. Then it the top, when we create a click, see if you zoom in, you will see that there it will be orange line. So if you do that, then it will be contacts will be your gate. Yes. So gate, we'll click on the gate. You will find the gate. Then again, we'll click that one, drain side, and right click. Then we'll see the contacts list, and we'll click on the gate drain. Then the drain contact will be placed. And in the body, we'll right click, select left by left click. We will select that one, and contacts will be body. So we have placed all 4 contacts. Okay. Now electrical contact has been made. Now, you see, that is the 4 different contacts. How can you visualize that? 4 are all the different colors. Now, by seeing only that, you can know, you know that all the contacts are different. Not the there is no repetition of contacts. Okay. So, this is a source contact, this is a gate contact, this is a drain contact, this is a body contact. You know that. Yes. Now, after that, we'll go to the mesh section. Now, what we have done? We have deposited all the materials, silicon, oxide, gate. We have placed the contacts for the electrical connection. Done. Now we have to do the doping. Now for the doping, you see that doping is different for this region is one type of doping, this region different type of doping, and for the drain region is a different type of doping. So we need to create 3 sections in this silicon body for the creation of the different dope region. That can be compared to the masking process. When we do the masking process, photolithography and those process of the fabrication can be compared to this. So what we'll do for the section, creating section inside the silicon layer, we'll go to the mesh. Then define real eval window. And what type of window we need? We need rectangular type. You see, all the windows are rectangular in both. If it is different inside, you can see polygon, cubital, from edge, or face, whatever you want. So, for my case, currently we only need rectangular one. So click on the rectangular. Okay, exit coordinate is already on. If it is not on, so you can check the exit coordinate here, but it is already on. So now you see, again we are tracking with the coordinate system. So this, see one that one circle behind that cursor is moving along with the cursor. So that means you are tracking the coordinates now. Okay, so exit coordinate. So now again we have to give the coordinates for creating this section. So first I want to create a section of this one, this source region. Means I need to select this vertex and this vertex, these two vertex. Obviously, so these two vertex, so one will be 0, 0, one will be 0.03, 0.03. So x axis 0, y is 0, and second vertex will be 0.03, final vertex will be 0.03. See, if you can. Now, I have not clicked OK. See, there is a only one piece of silicon. Now, when we will place the section, it will be divided into parts. We'll check that one also. So, 0, 0, 0.03, 0.03, and we'll press OK. When we'll press OK, it will create a box. It is not shifting, so it will create a box here. Okay, see, it is created a box, means that portion has been separated from other region, this region. Okay, now if we click again, so we have to format another box, that is the channel box. The channel box two vertex will be 0.03, 0 and 0.07, 0.03. When you are writing your vertex, you need to be very careful. Without that, you will have so many mistakes and perfect device will not be available with you after the preparation. So suppose starting with the 0.03 and y axis will be obviously 0, and second vertex 0.07 and y axis will be 0.03 obviously, and we'll press OK. Then we'll see that the second box also forms. See, the first box is there, second box is there. Now we left with the third box. We need to the third, define third region. For third region, we'll select this 0.07, 0 and 0.1, 0.03. So first vertex will be 0.07, y axis will be 0, and second vertex will be 0.1, 100 nanometer, and y axis will be 0.03. And when you press OK, we'll say that three boxes. All the three boxes have been formed in our this simulator. Okay, so when boxes are already prepared, then what we'll do? We'll do the doping part. Okay, so in the doping part, what we'll see, we'll go to the device. After device, we see the constant profile placement. Okay, so constant profile placement. What will you do? Now we have in the fabrication comparability, if you do the comparable analysis of the fabrication, then means masking has been done. And in fabrication, what happened? One mask, then you do one type of doping, then you change the mask, remove the mask etching, then you do the another type of doping. So what is that? We have done all the masking process along with the in the single go, and now we will do the all the doping deposition process or doping process, all the doping processes in one. So for doping process device, constant profile placement. Now you see, previously what we have generated, defined real eval window. So you now see, you find we click on the device and go to the constant profile placement, then you will find that this real eval window. You will find that this real eval window, three windows you have generated, whichever you will select, that will be selected here. Okay. So one person asked me, in the starting of the session, sir, how can we define these regions or that one? You can define this in the region variable window, and you can choose the region also. This is the region one, region two. When we fabricated the device, that the three different region has been created. See, your maroon color has been changed from region one to region one, region three, region four. Okay. Why region 2 is not there? Because we have misplaced that one, that coordinate. So region 2 is not there. And if you can select also material wise, suppose you have a multiple stack device where suppose you multiple time, not a single go. This is a single go in the all the silicon regions are interconnected. Okay. So you can draw this one. But suppose you have suppose this in this box, suppose this channel region, suppose this channel region I'm defining by the color, okay, yes I got it. Suppose this region is done by the germanium. Your device is a silicon germanium based. So this side is silicon, you have germanium. So you want to do the same kind of doping in the both the side. Okay, now you can do it separately by using the real value window, but you can select these two, both your source at rate region by using this material. When you will metal use the silicon, then in place of gold, this middle place will be not be selected. All other silicon region will be selected. So in that case, you can use the material also. Or else you can define all the small small portion in the wherever you want some doping, or define reliable window also may be used for the meshing purpose. What is meshing? We'll see that one also. So this is the use of that one. Now if we want to see that one, how to do the doping. So we have constant profile placement mask. So we need to change this name when we have to the one. Okay, so now we will not do the as a dope material wise, we will do as per the window wise, as we have defined this window as per the specific doping concentration of this region. Means we have all the uniformity of this doping here. So we have selected the doping region. So doping will be placed in this source region only. The doping profile name is doping profile placement one. You can change that name also. It is better to be same name kept in here and the constant profile definition also here. So you can, it will be better if you keep same as it is, in the top and bottom both. So it is, we are creating NPN. So what is the n-type dopant? What is the n-type dopant? Arsenic is a one type of n-type dopant. Yes, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so here we'll take the arsenic. And what is the, how much, what's the doping concentration should be in the source region? The source region doping concentration should be 10 to the power 18. So we'll take the concentrations 1E18. So when we'll see that the concentration 1E18, that means the arsenic material will be doped in this source region, that is 30 by 30 nanometer of square box, with a concentration of 10 to the power 18. Okay. Now what we can do? We can do add placement. You see that one? That one blink was there. That means the doping has been done. Okay. So here is the corresponding line also has been generated. That is 1E18. If you see that one, 1E18 and real evaluable window 1. Okay. Along with that, you can say next doping in the channel region. So channel region, our real evaluable window 2. We have selected the real evaluable window 2. And we have to need to change the placement name also. or else later it will be problematic. Okay, now constant profile displacement 2, arsenic concentration. Now we need to do P-type. P-type is a boron is whatever P-type material, and we need to do 5 into 10 to the power 16. So we'll have the 5E16. So it will be 5 into 10 to the power 16. Okay, so it now if we it is we have selected 2, we have changed the constant profile placement name, cross checked, boron, that is P-type, concentration matched. Now we can add the placement. See, placement added. Okay, now we are selecting the real evaluator 3. That is the real evaluator 3. Now we have doing a constant profile placement 3. This is a constant profile placement 3. This is the we have selected the real evaluator 3. The constant profile placement for the window 3 will be 3. And now we need to add a n-type doping. So n-type doping means we need to add, let we can add arsenic, or if you want to add anything other else, you can from other you can find many more also. So you can add 1, 8, again 18. Okay, so again cross check window 3, available window 3, yes, correct, less than 3, constant profile dimension 3. So all here is 3, correct. Arsenic concentration, arsenic tip concentration, 1 into 10 to the power 18, correct. Add placement. Now we have done with all our device manufacturing process. We have deposited all the materials. We have created the contacts. We have done with the doping. All the things you have done. Now what we need to do for the simulation, what we need to do to prepare this device for the simulatable, because if it is in the whole device, it can't be simulated right in this condition. We need to do it more exercise for the simulation purpose. What in the simulation, what do we do? We need actually solve the question of causing according to the equation which we have solved. We have checked in the modeling purpose also that we solve this equation. Okay, so these equations similarly solve in this industrial simulator also. Okay, so where will solve? It can't be solved in the whole. So we have to create small boxes where it will be solved. And actually, Poisson equation what will give the your potential equation. Potential equation means where each and every point it will calculate the potential from this device and how much it's as much as small it will be as much as good result or accurate result it will be. Okay. So for that, so we need to define small window here. For that is for the meshing of the device. Okay. So then again we'll go to the mesh, then refinement placement. If we have a 2 to 3 minutes break, let me drink some water. Okay, let's start again. Now we have a refined placement 1, means we are giving refined placement 1 is the refined your where from where we got this from the mesh and the Refinement placement. Refinement placement means how much small boxes you want to define. So this is the placement one, and you see you can select here also. You can select in three different partitions like the previous. You can select through the reliable window for the material, through the region wise. Region wise means materials means earlier we have defined that suppose channel will be replaced by the your. So channel can be replaced by this germanium part. So if you want to fabricate this one, you can define whole the silicon at a time, and then you can use overlap. We have already told you that there is an overlap section is there in the cross section. Last time we told you that now it's a new replace one. Means what? It's new when you will done will do a. In a single way, you formulated this or deposited this whole silicon. After that, you have fabricated or you have defined this germanium region. So, germanium is the latest one. So germanium will be replaced this region, this silicon. So, now this silicon will be present over here and over here, but it was defined in a single way. So, that one, it is a two different portion, but it is in the created in the single go. That means it will be. Considered as a single region. So that region will be, suppose this one, this region will be whole, you have created in the whole group. At a single click, what portion you will be created, that will be into your one region. This each and every deposition will be created as a one region. We can define this total one, in place of one region, we can define the three regions also. So then drain, then channel. So you can, if we separately we deposited three sections of the silicon, then it will be become the 1, 2, 3 region. Okay, so it can be region wise also. The region 2 we have defined that one, and region 2 we have defined that metal section. Or you can go for the with the metals, materials, or you can go with the real world. See, we have defined the real world window for these three portion only, means on the silicon only. So that's why in the real world window we can select these three only. Okay, so for the refinement placement, we'll first do the refinement placement in the silicon that box. So let's first decide the how much. Okay, so let's first decide the your region. What will be the region? Okay, now suppose for this one, and for this one. So if you see that maximum person says that whatever things are going on that are mainly happened in the channel region of your MOSFET, means all the effect passed through here, first layer of structure, deformation, accumulation, all the things are going on where? In the channel region. So our main interest is this channel region. So we'll keep as much as low possible in this channel region. Okay, so for the meshing size, we need to give two meshing size. Okay. One is min, one is max. If you see that there, yes, you see that is the maximum, means that will be generated as a maximum minimum two section will need. And what is this? I will explain to you. Max and another one will be min. Okay, so for max, if you suppose you are thinking about your X maximum Means, suppose your total thickness is 30 nanometer, so 40 nanometer, and you have defined the minimum length is 3 nanometer. Okay, so if it is a 13 box place, that means 1 nanometer is left here. You can't place a 3 nanometer length box in a 1 nanometer region. What I am saying, you're getting, means we have 14 nanometer of length. And we have placed 3 nanometer. So 13 box, if we placed, we have power to come 3 into 13 means 39 nanometer. We are left with the only 1 nanometer here. So we can place there. So there you will, program will see how, what is the maximum, minimum box capacity there. So if it is minimum is 1, then what will happen? You will set that one box, one length box here, and it will complete the meshing. Okay, so that's why two meshing parameters need to be taken, the maximum and minimum. Suppose for the minimum, you are taking, suppose, exponent 2, 1, sorry. For minimum, you are taking, suppose, both the x and y 1. And for maximum, you both the case you are taking 2. Okay, that is not the exactly coordinate. That is the maximum y value and maximum x, the maximum x value, y value, maximum. It can be represented. Well. Okay. Or similarly, this is the minimum expel and while. Okay. So if you see that one. Whereas as compared to that one, drain side has less importance or less thing is going on the drain side. So we can keep it little bit higher. We can keep it in the same way also that much low, but it can be keep it higher as that the as much as the machine size will be small, the iteration will be more because number of boxes fitted in that particular region will be more. That means the more number of iteration required is, you require the solution time will be more. So if we don't require that much of precision or those regions we are not that much of interested in, so that region we can place higher type of meshing. So we can get the optimum result also at minimum minimum running time or minimum execution time. So there we let's see, we can take maximum value as a 5 and minimum value as a 3. So we are keeping as a little bit big box. And similar thing, we suppose we are also considered for the source region also. Okay, so these three conditions we are taking. Now we will place the same mesh refinement placement. Now placement 1 for the real level window 1. Real level window 1 means your source window. Source window, what is the maximum? 5, 5 and 3, 3. So, the iteration is not there, so you can place it 0 and 0. Okay, so create refinement. Oh, sorry. Not 5, it will be, okay. Means we are defining in the micrometer, obviously, so it will be 0.005. Okay. And again, it will be 0.005. Okay. So I'm doing in the one part and same will be applicable for the rest, all other part also. 0.003, again, 0.003. Mesh refinement placement. So meshing x direction will be 0.005, y direction will be 0.005 direction 0, same x direction 0 point minimum value. So minimum element will be 0.003 and 0.003. Okay, and y direction 0. So we have defined the one for the real equivalent to 1. Yes, then we have defined the definition 1, and it is 0.00 by 5 nanometer, 5 nanometer by 3 nanometer, 3 nanometer. Okay, create refinement, then it will create the refinement has been created. Okay, good. Now we'll do the second one. Second one means for the second window. For the second window, it will select to that will be our channel. Okay, so we'll go to the one by one. So second window, it will be 0.002, because 2 nanometer by 1 nanometer 0.002, again here 0.001 and 0.001, again 0. So we have done this maximum element 2 nanometers, so z direction 0, element size minimum 1 nanometer, and we have selected the channel region really by number 2, defined placement 2, definition 2, and now we can cross check everything, create the refinement. Done. Now we will select the third real window, and get real window, your refinement placement will be 3, your definition will be 3, okay, and your maximum element size will be again how much? 5533. So it will be 5 nanometer. 0.005 nanometer, 0.003 nanometer, 0.003 means 3 nanometer, and 0. So we have selected the third real equivalent window. We have refinement placement 3, and we have get the definition, refinement definition 3, and all the parameters we have declared. Means all the maximum minimum is declared, and create the refinement. Create refinement. Done. Now we'll close this, because we have done the meshing. Now we'll check the whether meshing has been done successfully or not. So checking that, we'll go to the mesh, we'll go to the build mesh, and we'll again press the build mesh. Now we'll wait. What will happen? It will generate a device, whatever we have fabricated with the materials, different materials, and with the meshing menu. Okay. We have to wait for little 1 to 2 minutes to software to process and generate the output. In the meantime, if you have any question, you can ask me. Yes, it is written that machine is successful. Yeah.
Okay. So you can proceed. The question or questions we can take afterwards, right?
Okay. So here you see that meshing is successful, it is written, meshing is successful, mesh means meshing successfully generated. Now at one window also will appear, but it will take some time. Okay, it will take some time. See, there is coming. Okay, let me have it. Okay, all the this is the meshing lines. You see that these are the different region. How can you visibility? You can check them. So this is the mesh line. You can see the mesh. If you unselect this one, that meshing will be disappear. Okay, you can select that or unselect that. If this depends on you. You see that doping concentration, it is showing that 1 into 10 to the power 18 maximum, that is 1 into 10 to the power 18, 1 into 10 to the power 18. Okay, and minimum is minus 5 into 10 to the power 16. Minus 5 means it is in the P type. So that is the P type, minus 5 into maximum 16. And if you see the meshing, Okay. Now, if you see that meshing, so it is y will be in direction and x is in this direction. So you will see that your, this is the source section, this is your drain section, this is your channel section, and channel section that you getting the very small boxes. Okay, now you see that there is a small, if you significantly is it visible, then you can see that this is, see, all the boxes of the have the uniform length and breadth, but there is a small boxes where we have created very small portion. That is the function of the minimum what we have given. The maximum is 2 by 2, but minimum is 1. It can be 1 by 2, because see that side 2 is available, so it is taken 2, but that side 1 is available, so it is taken less than 1. Okay, and that side is created in the junction. In the case of junction, these boxes are created, which is not 2 by 2, it will be 1 by 1 only. Okay. So and from that it is gradually increasing the your meshing, and the higher quantity meshing has higher sizes meshing are there in the drain. So we have successfully created our MOS structure with 4 terminal, 3 regions, and 3 type of materials. Okay, now what next we need to do? We have left with the many one important work. Okay, after that, what we need to do? We need to suppose, well, now we can't use directly from here. That this tool can be used only for the generation part. We have generated this function. Okay, now what we need to do? We need to copy this command for using for, because this was Centros workbench is the main tool for simulating all the device and propagation of the device. You can direct, as we see earlier, that we can create new project. How to create new project? After that, how can you use these commands? We already generated the commands required to generate this device, and we have already successfully generated 8 device. We have no doubt on that. But how to use that one? How to use and how to keep that device for the future prospect, future analysis? So this is the total command what we got from this that one. Okay, let me save that one first. Save. Okay. Let's stop. Okay. So we have saved that one for the future purpose only. No. So we need to generate a project here. Okay. So now first we need to generate a project. After that project, okay. After become a little bit slow. Up to that point, if anyone have any question, you can ask.
So there are certain questions which participants have actually inboxed in the chat box.
Okay.
Shall I speak, or if you are able to see, or shall I? Okay, I'm just reciting it so you can actually see. The question is from Amit Bhattacharya. He said, how the molar factor of heterostructure can be changed? Say, X component of silicon germanium source.
You can actually, that is means, yeah, that is the silicon germanium file will be there in the material section. And the material section, silicon germanium, that means there the molar fraction will be directly defined in the, that portion also. And that thing you can also be, that will be fine. You need not to worry about that part in the S device, means central structure editor portion. you can only need to change when you are running the as visual, means when you are analyzing that one device. Device will directly identify the silicon germanium as a material, but how much mole fraction is there in the silicon germanium, how much it is with silicon is 0.1, germanium is 0.9, or silicon is a 0.9 and germanium is a 0.1, that actually you can define in the material file of this device, or you can define in the parameter file. Okay. And another that one question. I will go tomorrow also, we'll give the real short view on that.
Okay, there is another question from Chinmay Dimri. He asked, can you please show how to add interface traps to the device?
Yeah. This again, this part also can be done in the S device that it will discuss tomorrow. That means when you are fabricating the device or you are preparing the device, you need not to worry about these parts. Okay, you just have to think about what can be done in the to prepare the device. Do we have just preparing the device? All the conventional, unconventional effects, temperature, trap, and all other things can be incorporated in the or defined in the physics section only. Okay, so that is in the tomorrow's presentation or tomorrow's demonstration, where we'll analyze the S device or the simulation. How can we use the S device file for the simulation?
Okay, sir. Next question is that has been asked by Saurabh Jaiswal. Sir, how to add Gaussian profile?
Again, I'm saying that Gaussian profile, or you want to the doping Gaussian profile, then there is a direct command also there in this S device file that how can you change the doping profile as a Gaussian profile. Okay, now we are currently using the constant profile placement. Means it is throughout the device, it is a constant. If you want to Gaussian, then it's a different command, and that is available in your TCAD manual. Manual, all the tools has the different manual. I can do that one.
Okay, sir. Another last question is there from Sujay Raut. He is asking, instead of taking a Revel window, if we take 3 block of silicon, is there any difference will be made?
No. Either actually there will be no difference, but software will create a silicon to silicon junction. That is you can say that silicon also, they have a dangling bond, and there is a silicon to silicon dangling bond interfaces problems also somewhat little bit can be there. Okay, in the simulation, so result can be varied by a very negligible amount. We can't be seen in the blank eye also, but when you are taking the result, suppose you are measuring the current. Suppose off current for one device is 1 into 10 to the power minus 14, then other one will be 1.5 into 10 to the power 14. So that much significant difference is there in the software when you will use different regions, individual regions. Otherwise, it will better if you take it as a one region, because I suggest, because it will more resemble like a fabrication process. So whenever you are creating your device, you just think that how much you can get exact replica of your fabrication process.
One thing more, one last question from Saurabh Jaiswal. He asked that, is the sequence that you showed today, their steps order can be changed or not?
That is a standard sequence. You can change these steps. Means suppose you want to place contacts later on, or you can do that also. That is no issue. That's not the big issue. But when you are defining the real eval window, you need to find out that whether what we need to do first and what needs to do second. Because whenever you are doing the real eval window or making that one, that is means it is segregating your device. So it is better to keep the contact before that. And after that, what does the sequence? This is the only one thing. This creation of the contact and adding of the contact, that can be kept. It can be done in the later part also, but it depends on the how what type of device you are manufacturing, or you have to deploy a device you are simulating. So it's a device structure, depends on the device structure. But All other steps, it is a sequential wise, because first you will do the region wise, region, declare the region, or deposit the material, then you will do the segregation for the doping, then you will do the doping, then you will give the meshing. So this is the sequential process. You need to maintain
sir,
this sequence.
Sir, good afternoon, sir. Yeah, sir, good afternoon. Sir, one more question is that you have shown that the maximum and the minimum values that you have selected, the 5:5 and 3:3, 5:2:3. So how these values are taken? What concept that we can use there to identify that what is the maximum and what is the minimum values there?
I am giving you a rough idea how what can be done for this. Actually, when we are doing the simulation, we always do the calibration process. Okay. And meshing, when you change the meshing, that means that changing the meshing means you will actually change the all the whatever you have means result will be generated. If you change the meshing, the result will be changed. That is definitely okay. And that change is very much high, or very difference is very high. So when you doing your preparing as a simulation setup, that time you do the calibration process. That is the means one of the key important aspect of the simulation, because in simulation we can generate any kind of result. We can generate kind of thing, but 20 of INF ratios by taking any value. So that time it is very much important to calibrate your simulation setup with the industrial verified result. Means industrial verified result means you will take a industrial simulator where you will simulate your device, and there you will check that whether this device or means whether which industrial device, and selecting the industrial simulator, then selecting the industrial device. That device should be similar to what you are going to manufacture. Okay. So what is your intended device? It should be similar to this one. Second, first point. Then, second point is that you, 1 minute. Second point is that you need to find out the IDVG characteristics or some output characteristics or transfer characteristics of that fabricated result, fabricated device result. So you need to find from that. Okay. When you have done these two things, then what you need to do, you need to simulate that fabricated device in your simulation setup. And then you will find some difference. There maybe at 1 volt, their current is 10 to the power 9. You will find out the 10 to the power 11 or 10 to the power 8, 10 to the power 6. That means that device in actual scenario is generating 10 to the power 10 current, 10 ampere current. But you are getting 10 to the power 6, means you are overestimating something, or you are getting 10 to the power 12, that is underestimating something. So you need to, in that case, you can do one thing, you can adjust your meshing. Okay, so in that way only you can finalize your meshing. There is a no shortcut or no direct 100% guaranteed way that in this way your meshing will be work. Okay. So in this, that way, you can finally figure out the which meshing you should be select and which meshing should be ideal for you for the future analysis. And that part actually many researchers shows in the technical manuscript also that we have done this one, we have finally got this value, and that kind of calibration we have done. So that thing also has been shown by their different researchers. So it is a good way to do that, and that should be done by the every researcher, because without that, simulation can generate any kind of result. There is no validation of this result. That validation is only the calibration, that when you compare or you say that you do that I'm getting this result after the calibration.
Okay, any more questions, participants?
Okay. I need to show one thing, but how to use this one, but their net disconnectivity is there in server, so it will take hardly 3 to 4 minutes.
Okay, so any more questions, participants, you can actually unmute yourself or inbox it. So meanwhile, we can take up a few more questions.
Yes.
And please fill the feedback form. I have already shared the link in the Meet.
I think it is presenting right now. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Okay. So what we'll do when we'll So in the meantime, let me. So we have this code, which is. Okay. So we have generated this code. Okay. As you see, this one. So this we have copied from the below section of this that one. While we have seen that, we told many times that we have found that this code will this will come. This will to the all the. Means that code can be directly generated same function what we have done for the drawing. So this way we need to omit all the unnecessary component from this one, as it can be significant or it's suitably run in our simulator directly can generate the results. So we are deleting the all the unnecessary components. So how we'll find out the unnecessary components? Whatever present in the first bracket, that is your necessary component. All else, whatever it is there, this is all are unnecessary components. Let me do one thing. So today we should stop this presentation because there's a server failure due to the dropping of the internet connection. So we'll resume that section. Means we have successfully completed the demonstration of the central structure editor. So tomorrow we'll use this command. Whatever you are saying in this field, we will use this command, and we'll try to generate. The using this one will try to generate the device in the central's workbench, not in the central device editor, in the central's workbench, and then we'll use the S device file and what are the components can be used in the S device file that we discuss, and we'll try to generate some result also, and we can check that how can the result can be generated. So we'll see that visualization part also tomorrow. So tomorrow we'll give the complete best idea, and whoever asking for the trap and all other things, we'll also give you the how can you use the trap and how far you need to use it. Okay. So I think let's stop the today's session here, and I think we have taken the query also. So if you have any queries, then we'll wait for 4 or 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes more. And then we'll stop our session. In the meantime, if you want anything, you can directly say anything.
So participants, if any queries are there, please convey us either either unmute yourself or inbox it, and also kindly fill the feedback form for sure if the link has been already shared in the dialog box. And because during the session only we will be sharing a feedback form, so kindly fill it.